Lift the feet and shins off the ground, lean out, take a big inhale, and as you exhale, lower halfway to the floor, elbows in, modified chaturanga. Lower all the way to the ground, release the feet and shins to the floor. Slide the hands back an inch, take an inhale, lift the chest, roll the shoulders back, cobra. Next, keep your feet where they are and walk your hands to your feet to the back of your mat. Take an inhale and glance out. Either climb onto the fingertips or slide the hands up the shins to create a flat back. If you feel this is a little premature for your hamstrings, put a soft bend in the knees. Exhale, fold forward. The big toes are pressing into the ground. Additionally, turn your back foot forward, more to 45 degree angle. This will help square the hips. Sink a little bit deeper into the front knee so it rests over the front ankle. You can use your hands to further the squaring of the hips, pushing your right hip back and drawing your left hip forward. Reach your arms to the sky and draw on the abdomen and lift the heart for warrior one. Now straighten the front leg for triangle pose, Uddita Trikonasana. An alternative method is to rest the right hand on the right shin if you prefer not to use a block here. Open your mouth and let it go. Let's move into the second side. Place your hands on your hips and step your right foot back 3.5 to 4 feet behind you. Make sure your back heel is down, setting up for warrior one, Virabhadrasana. Just reaching far enough forward so that you can still maintain a flat back and that you feel a stretch in the backs of the legs and the elongation of your spine. Take a big inhale and exhale, come to center. Take your right arm and wrap it around the front of the legs. Take your left hand and cup the floor 6 inches out from your tailbone. Take a big inhale, lift the chest, then exhale, twist, pulling your heart to the left. Take a big inhale, then exhale, set your feet on the floor, and let's lay on your back. Step your feet together and drift to upper push-up. Take your right hand 1 or 2 inches close to the left. Kick both heels off to the right and send your left arm to the sky for side arm balance, Vashisthasana. Exhale, lunge your right foot between your hands closest to your right thumb. Drop your left knee to the floor and slide your left leg back, stretching the left quadricep. Then reach your arms to the sky for modified crescent pose, Ardha Anjayasana. Your left shoulder in line with the right shoulder. Flex the left heel and then send your left arm to the sky for the fullest expression of the pose. And as you exhale, release your hands to prayer. Follow with another inhale, then exhale, warrior two. Spin the back heel down, turn your chest to the right, and open the arms to the sides like wings. Half close your eyes, focus on slowing the breath in your tiptoe pose. In this asana, we're working the slow twitch, fast twitch muscles in the body and establishing mental clarity. Cross your right ankle over the top of your left thigh just above the knee. Flex the right heel and emphasize coasting the right knee forward. Feel the release in the right hip and the opening of the chest. If you want to deepen the stretch, try bringing the left heel closer to the left sit bone to intensify this pigeon pose variation. And exhale, mindfully twist your chest to the left. Remember, if you want more, take your left arm behind the lower back and hook the left fingers in the inner right hip and thigh to deepen the rotation. Take a big inhale. And exhale, set the legs down, but keep them in tree position. Bring the left knee to point up to the sky. Take your right hand and hold onto the outside of the left knee. Look to the left. Take a big inhale, and as you exhale, twist the left knee to the right for final twist.